Hello everyone. Welcome to this video on how to create an RDLC report using the Bold Reports Report Designer. Before creating a report, let me briefly introduce RDLC reports and some of the differences in creating them between Microsoft tools and Bold Reports. RDLC, Report Definition Language Client-Side, is a format created by Microsoft to integrate reporting functions within an application without any server. To create RDLC reports using Microsoft tools, you must use Microsoft Report Designer within Visual Studio. To create an RDLC report with Bold Reports, you can create one in Bold Report Designer without any external application. The Microsoft Report Designer is used with .NET objects to pass data when creating a report, whereas in Bold Report Designer, you can use the latest dataset modes, like JSON, to pass data when creating a report. In this video, I will demonstrate how to create an RDLC report that displays product details using Bold Report Designer. You can create the RDLC file using the standalone Report Designer, which is a free reporting tool provided by Bold Reports. I have provided the video link for the steps to install the standalone Report Designer in the video description for your convenience. Now, let's get started. Launch the Bold Reports RDLC Designer from the Windows Start menu. First, I create the dataset from which I will add the necessary data to the report. I change the dataset name to Sales Dataset for this report. Next, I need to add the required data fields with their appropriate data types so that data fields can be used in the report. Here, I add product category, subcategory, order year, order quarter, and sales with proper data types. After adding these, I save the dataset. Before adding the table, let me add a header to this report to describe the basic information of the report. To do that, I enable the header area. Add a rectangle that acts as a container for the header text. And resize it. Next, I change the background color to enhance the look and feel. To add the header text, add a text box inside the rectangle and add the label sales by product since the table displays the product sales information. Next, format the text by changing the font, color, size, weight, and vertical alignment. If you see extra space around the text, you can resize the text box and rectangle so that the spacing between the text is adjusted. Now, the header has been added. Next, I need to add a table which displays the product sales details. I add a table and add the necessary columns, and then add product category, subcategory, order year, quarter, and sales as headers. And format them. Then, I assign its corresponding values in the data row and format them. Since a currency value must be displayed in the currency format, I select the sales value cell and change the format to currency with 2 decimal points and use the 1000 separator. Once the values are assigned to the table, I need to apply some basic formatting to the table to enhance its look and feel. I select the header row and change the font family, weight, and background color. Finally, I will show you how to add the JSON data to the RDLC report and view it. Since the RDLC report does not contain any data connector, I am going to pass the data as JSON data to preview the report. Click Preview in the top panel to open the Preview Data pop-up, where we will add the JSON data, The key names in the input JSON array should be the same as the data field name provided in the dataset creation, and the field value will be the value that needs to be displayed in the report. Now, preview the report. You will see the table displays the product sales details with the values provided from the JSON data. In this video, I have shown you how to create a simple RDLC report and display data in it using Bold Report Designer. You will find a link to the blog used in this tutorial in the description below. I have also included links to videos on how to use the created RDLC report in web and desktop applications for your reference. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.